COVID-19 has taken the world by storm, and with increasing limits on social gatherings, self-isolations, and spreading fear, it is a real threat to our entire financial system. In this episode, we will illustrate the impact that the deadly virus has already shown on some stocks. If we look at some of the players in the entertainment space, such as Cinemark, IMAX, and AMC, we can observe that their stock prices have dropped by an average of 70% so far in 2020. This is not really surprising. Theaters are one of the biggest social gathering places. When more and more people stop going to the cinemas, a lot of studios were quick to announce a delay in movie releases. Think of a new James Bond movie, No Time to Die. Now that we're midway through March, most of the theaters are just plain closed. Theater companies are bleeding a lot of cash since they have no income streams to support their fixed operating costs. Food distributors such as Sysco, US Foods, and Performance Food fell by an average of 69% year-to-date. Quick service restaurants and regular restaurants are experiencing lower traffic. Some of them are still operating because they have the resources to offer takeout or delivery options. But there are many others that are not so fortunate and are closed completely for the next few weeks. Therefore, food distributors are experiencing a significant decrease in the number of orders. The whole travel and tourism industry has suffered because of the domino effect. People around the globe have delayed their travel plans, and governments have closed their borders to prevent the spread of the virus. First, we see that online travel companies such as Expedia, Booking.com, and TripAdvisor have suffered from lower trip bookings, and their stock price has dropped on average by 44% year to date. Since people are not following through with their travel plans, it means the transport system that supports the tourism industry also takes a hit. Delta, United, and American Airlines dropped on average by 53% year to date. As numerous TikTok videos have shown, prices of airplane tickets are now at ridiculously low levels. Hashtag cheap flights. In turn, hotels experience lower reservations. Hilton, Marriott, and Wyndham experience a 50% average drop in their stock price year to date. The few hotel guests who are still at the hotels essentially get the whole hotel for themselves. Sounds pretty sweet. But then again, what's the use if most of the hotel staff is not there to operate all the amenities? If we turn to tech companies, we can observe that the virus has not spared them either. For example, Apple has temporarily closed most of its stores. We see here that Apple, Alphabet, and Microsoft have dipped by an average of 13% year to date. E-commerce companies have fared better than others. JD.com, a Chinese e-commerce company, is performing pretty well given the impact of the virus on the Chinese economy. Amazon will probably turn to grain in the following weeks when online orders will pick up from more people staying at home. Amazon, JD.com, and Alibaba have on average declined by 4% year to date. Retailers such as Walmart, Kroger, and Costco are performing pretty well. People are rushing to these stores to stock up on staple goods and toilet papers for some reason. On average, these retailer stocks have posted a 6% gain year to date. Not all pharmaceutical companies are in the race to find a treatment for the virus. But Regeneron, Moderna, and Gilead are working hard on finding one. These three companies saw their stock prices rise by an average of 29% year-to-date. Now let's look at some of the best performers year-to-date. Clorox, Citrix, Digital Realty, and General Mills. It makes sense to see Clorox's uptick in stock price from this unfortunate crisis. A big chunk of its revenues come from cleaning products, such as bleach and wipes. As more people are working from home, it makes sense for Citrix to outperform the market. Citrix offers a digital workspace platform for employees to access apps, data, and communications on any device, over networks, and in the cloud. And right now, employers are embracing Citrix products. Digital Realty Trust provides wholesale data centers. Think of them as providing the space companies need to store and run their servers. As more and more people work from home, data consumption will spike. What will most people do at home in isolation? The majority of their time will be spent using the internet. Maybe watch Netflix, YouTube videos, and definitely connect via social media. General Mills provides consumer foods. Known branded goods include Cheerios, Yoplait, and Progresso. Basically, the products that people will stockpile on during social distancing. Eat away their cereal, yogurt, and canned soup while watching Netflix. Our financial system is built upon interdependent business activities. It's kind of like a drag-along, tag-along case. It's natural for most industries to be in the red when the power of consumerism is dialed down. What do you think about the current stock price levels? Do you think that the declines reflect overreaction from investors? Should the government ban trading for a long period of time? Let us know.